the America's Public Radio proudly presents Uncommon. Yes, Uncommon Recordings by Uncommon People. The year was 1945. In a small studio in Hollywood outside of NBC, Lester William Polsfuss, also known as Les Paul, and Bing Crosby, who had already been together for 5 years making music for the foundation of the Armed Forces Radio Network, they are now joined by Decca Records. These were the very first recordings of Les Paul and Bing Crosby in that Monroe Street studio outside of NBC, in his garage. I believe it was the very first garage band, or the very first independent studio that was ever developed. Engineered solely by Les Paul and his associates, it cost over $656 to build. What came out of that studio was quite a large number of stars. Andre Previn, of course, Bing Crosby had already been from Spokane, Washington, well known during the war years. But the most important thing was the independent nature of what was going on. It was a pioneering sound that caught the eye of Capitol Records, who for 2 years became quite confused of where all this material was coming from. There were actually very few electronics between the microphone and the home-built lathe that Les Paul developed. It was a remarkable sound that revolutionized the recording industry. Yes, out of a 1945 homebrew studio came some of the most remarkable, high-quality recordings from the microphone right into the disc itself, without any tape, which had not quite been developed yet here in America. But it was about ready to make its prominence in the next few years with the help of Bing Crosby and Les Paul. So tonight we're going to have a little bit of background of where all this came from. So Les, what happened?
I says, Bing, spent a couple hours trying to find a studio, a place to build a studio for me. He said, why in the hell didn't you take it? And I said, nah, I don't want to get involved in that. And my two friends, Lloyd and Vern, said, well, you know what you could do? You could build one right here. Just take this garage right here and turn it into a studio, and you could do practically anything you wanted in a small way. So I said, what do you think it would cost? So my one friend, Lloyd, he says, well, I can do all the building. So he says, how are you with the saw, Les? I said, I'm good. I can do all that. He says, well, the parts and everything else, counting the nails, and he counted out to the last nail, the last board, and the last bucket of paint, cost $165. So I said, Vern, what's it going to cost for the electronics? And Vern says, well, to build a recording lathe, we're going to build a recording lathe. And to do the whole thing, let's say the studio, everything should cost you $665. I says, let's go. And we started. And we built that studio in the garage. And out of that studio came, I don't know how many artists that went with Capitol. And at that time, I wasn't with Capitol yet. But at that time, Capitol Records was above the Wallach's Music Store, upstairs. Now this is 45, and I'm now doing very well. I've done Jazz at the Philharmonic, which was a big, big hit. That very first record ever, okay? So not only was I the first to do TV out of New York, but I was in 1939, but I was the first one to do a live performance, a jazz performance from the stage. They'd never done that before. Norman Graves was the first to do that. I was the only white guy in the act, and I was the only fellow in the armed forces to play with at that time. I had to wear a uniform. Meredith would not let me take my uniform off, but he let me play the date, which turned out to be very successful. Back to the story. We build the studio, and out of the studio came Judy Conova, was the very first record ever made in that backyard. And then a little guy named Freddie Stewart, who went with Capital. Then Herb Jeffries, of course, the Andrews sisters, Bing Crosby, Gene Austin, Pee Wee Hunt, Calvin Jackson, Andre Previn, everything out of this little garage. Years later, Jim Conklin said to me, he says, you know, it took us a couple of years to figure out at Capitol Records that when we got a record that was made in your backyard, we signed up the act, and we were signing up the sound, not the act. And he says, you got such great sound, and you had a way of making these guys, bringing the best out of the guys. He says, we took that same artist, put him in our studio in Radio Recorder, and did it for Capitol, and then we dropped him. And he says, Jim Conklin will tell you this. Well, Jim said it took about 2 years before we figured out where was that recorded. That guy sounds good, you know. We had the Peggy Lees. We had everybody in the backyard.
And now, Les Paul's very first production in his brand new studio, Judy Conova, in Stars and Stripes over Iwo Jima.
When the Yanks raise the Stars and Stripes on Iwo Jima, through the blood and tears they won through. Let the heart of each Yankee there on Iwo Jima Isle, resting neath a blanket of blue. High on the hill, Suribachi, lies Old Glory, and she always will. When the Yanks raise the Stars and Stripes on Iwo Jima Isle, there were tears in their hearts, so they smiled.
When the Yanks raise the Stars and Stripes on Iwo Jima Isle, through the blood and tears they won through. Bless the heart of each Yankee there on Iwo Jima Isle, resting neath the blanket of blue.
High on the hill, Suribachi, flies Old Glory, and she always will.
When the Yanks raise the Stars and Stripes on Iwo Jima Isle, there were tears in their hearts, though they smiled.
For the America's Public Radio, this has been Gene Weed, your host. Stay tuned for the rest of the story.